Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. It's Monday. Am I allowed to make your head completely spin? Well, my head has been completely spinning with this question from Lo, sent in by Malaysia. Lo says, hey, I have a filtered data set here. I filtered it down to just the B's, and I'm trying to use the COUNTIF function. The COUNTIF function to count how many of those records are 2. Well, hey, let's look. 1, 2. The answer should be 2, but COUNTIF is not ignoring the rows hidden by the filter. And when I started to think about this, okay, there's only one function I know of that will ignore the rows hidden by the filter, and that's the subtotal. So, if I did a sum of C3 to C16, it's going to sum everything. But if I did a subtotal, the subtotal 9 will ignore the rows hidden by the subtotal. So I started to think about this. I said, well, if there's some way that we could get it to evaluate each row in this range and do a subtotal, subtotal 3, comma would actually count. That would give me a series of ones and zeros. And I made an attempt here, a very bad attempt that did not work at all. When I took a look at Y, evaluate formula, I saw that basically the subtotal piece was being evaluated as a single number. Right here, the subtotal was not being evaluated as every single cell from C3 to C17. It was just doing one evaluation, which evaluates to true, and that wasn't helping at all. So I said, certainly Aladin at the Mr. Excel message board would have a way to solve this. So I just go out to Google and I search for COUNTIF filter. And right there, third result, Mr. Excel message board, someone trying to do a very similar thing. Now, it took a couple of replies here, people trying, not understanding exactly what he was trying to do. And then all of a sudden, Ekim came in with one formula, and then Aladin came in with a beautiful sum product formula. Aladin is famous for these. So I adapted this formula, and we'll take a look at it in Excel. Basically, he's doing a subtotal. But he's doing it on, this is generating an array. So it's going to do many subtotals, one for every single row. He checks to see if that is, one or not. If it's visible, he's going to get a 1. If it's not visible, he's going to get a 0. And then he multiplies that by the criteria. So in this case, it was, we'd check it and see if column B was equal to a 2 instead of quality. So let's go take a look at this formula. Right here, I'm going to go, well, first of all, we'll look at the formula as I adapted it. We're looking at everything from C3 to C16, and then row of C3 to C16 minus the min row of C3 to C16. All that's doing is coercing Excel into evaluating the subtotal once for every single row. When we take a look at evaluate formula, what we should see is that we generate an array there. We generate an array there, and now the subtotal command needs to do not just one subtotal, but many subtotals. And there, perfect. We eventually coerce it into zeros and ones, the zeros being the hidden rows, the ones being the true rows. Now that I've gotten that, actually I didn't get that, Aladin got that. We then multiply it by our criteria, check to see if C3 to C16 is equal to 2. That's going to evaluate to false true, which is basically zeros and ones. Multiply everything together, and we get the correct answer, 2. And just to show you, if we would choose a different item, maybe A's, there's 2 there as well. Let's try something else, the C's. And there we only have 1, 2, so the formula is working perfectly. All right, so thanks to Lo for sending in that question. If you've never used the Mr. Excel message board, this is a perfect example of how collaboratively folks out there can come up with formulas that make my head spin. And thanks to Aladin, Aladin is the master of the sum product formula. He can, he can write formulas that will seemingly solve the impossible. And to be honest, I don't always understand what they're doing. I always take a look at evaluate formula, and I watch it work, and it's an amazing thing. So there you have it. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.